We are the PD Loggers. We're from NUS in Singapore. My name is Val. This is Daniel. Parkinson's disease people have problems with generating effective gait. And this leads to a shuffling gait that can lead to falls and injuries, also to excluding them from social circles. So what we want to do is to detect when this kind of ineffective steps happen, to give them biofeedback and help them get out of it. So we're going to use the Intel Edison, applying multiple sensors that acquire data of all the body parts, which we need to assess if it's going to if he's in that particular gait cycle or not. And then we're going to apply the algorithm on the Edison and apply the biofeedback then. Hopefully it's going to be applied to a lot of patients first in Singapore. We wouldn't mind, of course, to have this worldwide. 50% of Parkinson's disease people have these kind of problems. So we'd like to have most people use such a system.
The name of our team is Plan Chase, and we are from NTU. Basically, we are solving the issue of crowd management in Singapore. We are also developing a single automation standard using the crowd management data. We create a single automation protocol, so it takes care of everything, including the lighting as well as the aircon temperature, with the data. Suppose the number of people in this room increases, you know, so the aircon temperature should go down. We wanted a powerful computing device and small in size. So we are using Intel Edison to do image processing, image analysis, and Arduino breakout board to control various stuffs. I see my project everywhere, inside the giant supermarket, inside the in the MRTs.
Our team name is Hydrone, and we are from NUS. So we think that water is an important resource in Singapore, and we want to make water quality monitoring easier and more efficient to carry out. We are thinking of building a waterproof quadcopter that is easy to use, allows the collection of water samples more efficiently, and can provide greater areas that we can collect water samples from. We'll be using the Intel Edison board, and we'll be using it for its Wi-Fi capabilities and to use it for image processing. We are developing our quadcopter as a general platform that can be used for a wide variety of applications, such as wildlife monitoring or surveillance at maritime areas.
Our team name is SUTD Pandas, and we are from SUTD. Currently, we have seen that during peak periods, commuters tend to congest themselves on key areas such as the escalator landings and the lift landings. So our project aims to help disperse the commuters along the platform. So we are using this Intel RailSense camera to monitor the cabin density inside the train. Okay, so that in the incoming station, there'll be a module which will be able to display density info of each cabin, okay, onto the platform, such that commuters, when they see the different indications, okay, they can be directed to the different cabin doors. We hope to see it implemented in MRTs and maybe in other countries as well. Then, besides this data being just directly transferred onto the platform, it can also be used for optimization of how the platform is operated. For example, now actually they are directing the commuter flow by the escalators. Maybe the directions can be switched more efficiently with this data.
Our team name is Healthy, and we are from Ngee Ann Polytechnic. Our project is trying to solve the problem of cutting the time and the money spent for diabetic patients so that they can measure and monitor their blood sugar level at home rather than keep going to the doctor for checkups. Our project is basically a sensor that actually measures the glucose level in a patient's urine. We are using the Intel Edison kit, and the sensor will be used to detect the blood sugar level in the patient's urine. So obviously we'll be using the sensor, and it'll be a very heavy component of our project. We hope that the project can be used for many diabetic patients so that we can make their lives more convenient and give them an easier lifestyle. And we also hope to inspire other products of similar nature where we can detect and help different patients of different diseases monitor their health instead of them having to go to the hospitals here and there.
Hi, we are from NUS, and our team is called NUS Bowling. In Singapore, there are a lot of deaf people, and the deaf community, unfortunately, is growing bigger and bigger. Our project is trying to bridge this communication barrier by creating a glove that can translate sign language movement into words and letters, so we can allow those who are deaf and to communicate with the general public without the general public have to understand how actually sign language works. Because what they need to do is they just have an app on their phones, and while the deaf people are signing, they can actually wait and see, oh, this person is telling A, B, C, D, E, kind of thing. Yeah. We are using Intel Edison, and as we know, Intel Edison is a very powerful microprocessor, and our project, the Easy Glove we call it, we're gonna have a lot of data and reading from the flex sensors and accelerometer, and so the Intel processor is gonna help us tremendously in processing all this data in a very fast time, so we don't have to actually wait for, I don't know, a few seconds for it to come to our phone and all that, yeah. Okay, we hope to see that our project is going to be very helpful to the deaf community in wherever they go, wherever they do, so that they don't have to have the fear of, oh, will this person understand me if I perform sign language to him? So you just have to take out your phone and you perform sign language and the person will automatically understand you.